But what about Irene?
Maybe she'll get very rich and come into my restaurant someday. I'll be polite to her. I'll give her a good table and I'll be married to a nice girl who hasn't been in jail.
Come on, Karen, we're going round in circles.
Look, I have to go now. Albertia restaurant, nice place, fresh on Mathers. You come by one night, huh? Look, you're a nice lady. You want to stop worrying about girls from jail. Who can help them? Who cares?
None of the prisoner's complaints were acted upon, but he did find fault, grave fault, with the level of control I exercise over the prisoners and with my capabilities as a disciplinarian.
Well, I hate to tell you, but I told you so.
He has recommended some changes which materially affect you, Vera. I suppose I shall be the one to tell you.
It'd be the fair thing.
We are going to alter the system along the Fairley lines.
Fairley?
Yes. We are going to increase the number of male officers and staff, and I'm afraid I am going to have a male deputy governor.
But I thought,
Vera, you will still be a senior officer.
Sorry I had to call you in a bit earlier, but I want everything running as smoothly as possible.
I don't mind. What time's he arriving?
In about an hour. I don't know, Meg. I didn't think I was doing such a bad job.
You weren't!
The department doesn't see it that way.
I just wish the department would take notice of the changes you've made.
Perhaps a male officer is a good idea. We'll just have to wait and see. I hope Vera feels better about it this morning.
Ah, she'll get over it.
Yes.
Will you stop holding up the line, Anderson? And you don't need a double serve. Take some of that back.
Oh, Miss Bennett, I'm starving.
Well, you're not going to fade away, Anderson, are you?
Never mind, you can have some of mine.
And if you're not sitting down in a minute, you won't get anything. It's about time you lot learnt that this isn't a holiday camp.
That's right, we all got to help Vera win her Concentration Camp of the Year award.
Sausages, toast, tomatoes, tomates.
Tomatoes.
Right.
She doesn't need an English lesson in here, Travers. Keep moving.
Think of
all of them. Yeah, it's not like the old country, you know. We don't spend all day eating.
Sounds like your sort of country, then.
Watch it, Ferguson. What's the matter with you, Vera? Didn't you sleep last night? Don't push your luck, Smith.
Oh, it must have been the VJ said.
No, oh, didn't they give you the governorship?
Bet you can just see yourself behind that big desk, too.
Oh, I must be the sore spot.
Yeah, I wonder what he said to her.
Oh, who cares, as long as you're not in charge of us.
You're a pig, Anderson.
Oh, thank God I'm back on work release.
Yeah, but it's not much fun in the garden anymore.
Well, I thought you liked it.
Yeah, but not without you, Bart.
Well, I'm by myself at the nursery anyway, except for Mr. Butterfield. And besides, Doreen, say we were out flatting together or something. I mean, we'd still hardly see each other except when we got home from work.
Hey, yeah. Imagine that, us flatting together.
Oh, get a load of you two. You can't look after yourself for 2 minutes on the inside, let alone the outside.
I bet we could.
Oh, what are you on about, Doreen? They're never going to let you out.
Can't you do anything without making a mess, Birdsworth?
Oh. What's the big occasion, Vera? You're expecting a visit from the Queen or something.
You wanted to see me?
Mr. Fletcher has arrived. Sally is just bringing him up.
What do we know about him?
Well, his record's quite impressive. He had 10 years in Pentridge, and before that he was a sergeant in the regular army. He spent 3 years in Vietnam before being honorably discharged.
Very impressive.
I don't have to tell you, Miss Bennett, that I want his first impression of this prison to be a good one.
I'm sure he'll find everything running efficiently, Mrs. Davidson.
If I could have done anything to stop this appointment, I would have. But as things stand, we will make Mr. Fletcher as welcome as possible.
The deputy governor of a women's prison should be a woman.
Not necessarily. Fairley and some of the other women's detention centres have several male officers on their staff. Come in.
Mr. Fletcher, Mrs. Davidson.
Thank you, Sally. Welcome to Wentworth, Mr. Fletcher.
Thank you, ma'am.
I'd like you to meet two of my senior officers, Miss Bennett and Mrs. Jackson.
Hello.
How do you do?
Sit down, Mr. Fletcher.
I'd rather stand if that's all the same, ma'am.
I'm sure you'll find it slightly different working here than at Pentridge. We're a smaller detention centre, and we like to make things as flexible as possible.
So I've been told, ma'am.
I wonder if you wouldn't mind calling me Mrs. Davidson.
Sorry, Mrs. Davidson, I guess I've been too long in the army.
Well, perhaps if I tell you briefly how we operate...
Yes, I'd rather see the operation for myself, if that's all the same, ma'am.
Yes. Well, I'll introduce you to the women, and then Mrs. Jackson can show you around. I hope you'll be happy here, Mr. Fletcher.
I can see it all now, Lizzie. A tall, dark, handsome man is coming along to take you away from all this.
Yeah, when?
I'd say tonight. Depends on whether you can dream him up or not.
Here, give that back, you rotten little thief. I hope I choke you.
Oh, go on, Lizzie. You've had two helpings already.
So what? I've got to keep your strength up, haven't I?
It's all right if you're big in your stomach anyway.
Oh, it's more than I can say for you, you great big fat
horse. Give it a rest, you two.
Windbag, windbag.
Ooh.
Oh. Right, settle down, please, girls. This is Mr. Fletcher. He is taking over as deputy governor.
Well.
I want you to know that this is a departmental decision, and Miss Bennett will continue on as senior officer.
Oh, I knew it was too good to be true.
I expect you to help Mr. Fletcher in every way.
Too right.
And I do not want to hear that you've been giving him a hard time.
Oh, I guess I have a chance.
Carry on.
That must have been the tall, dark, handsome stranger you were telling me about.
I should have put my order in years ago.
He can put his uniform under my bunk any time.
I've tossed you for it.
All right, you heard the bell. Move out.
Well, 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 Vera. Don't tell me they're waking up to you at last.
Yeah, lost your job, did you, Miss Bennett?
Now, that's what I call real justice.
Could have been better, but...
Yeah, they could have fired you, Vera.
Wipe that grin off your face, Travers.
Oh, I'm sorry, Miss Bennett. I didn't know my feelings were that obvious.
Now, get out of my sight.
Hi. Good morning.
Good morning.
Can you spare me a moment?
Sure.
Okay.
Oh, I'll see you later.
Bye, Lynn.
Bye.
Excuse me, Miss Bennett, could I see Irene Zervas for a moment?
Didn't I tell you to get going?
Yes, I asked her to stay. I need a translator for the girl. Surely that's not too much trouble.
And we've started work and study release programs, so we are getting there.
Oh, don't let us interrupt, Miss Bennett.
You've got 5 minutes. I'll get the Zervas woman.
Mrs. Travers? She one of the women on work release?
No, she's studying sociology.
She's married?
She was.
Do you think these rehabilitation programs work?
Well, a lot of the women don't even have an occupation when they come in here.
Yes, I take it you're referring to the single women?
No, a lot of the married women would like to learn a job too.
Well, wouldn't it be better if you teach them to look after their families first?
Some married women have to work.
Yeah, but there's a difference between wanting to and having to, isn't there?
I'll introduce you to Dr. Miller.
Irene, your brother and sister-in-law are going to be allowed to stay in Australia. They're not going to be deported.
Australia? Actually, she already knows that. Alex and Tessa, menone edo.
Ne, alithia. Πολύ ωραία. Έχεις μιλήσει σε κανέναν και για μένα?
I'm not sure what she means.
Well, tell her that... Alex has paid her fine and that she's going to be released today.
Oh, that's marvellous. Let me see. Fine. Alex has paid... money, that's lefta. Alex... πληρώθηκε.
Ναι, μάλιστα.
Ελεύθερη σήμερα.
Σήμερα ελεύθερη. Ευχαριστώ πάρα πολύ. Ευχαριστώ, ευχαριστώ.
Well, I think she gets the message.
Right.
Γεια σας και ευχαριστώ πάρα πολύ. Thank you.
Ευχαριστώ.
So, what do you make of Wentworth?
Well, I haven't seen much of it yet.
Well, all I can say is I'm glad to see another male face around. I tend to feel surrounded. Come, make yourself at home.
Thank you.
The only advice I can give you is that just when you think everything's nice and peaceful, you know something's about to happen.
Yes, I have a fair idea what goes on in prisons.
Yeah, I didn't mean... What made you get into this line of work, Jim?
Well, I joined the army when I was 17. I'm not much qualified to do anything else.
Was it much of a switch from the army to Pentridge?
Well, no, not really. I'm used to discipline.
Pentridge is a bit different to Wentworth, I would imagine. So a lot more freedom here, for one thing.
So I've heard.
Why did you want to transfer here? Was it a promotion?
A promotion? To a woman's prison?
Lizzie, when are you going to learn to knock?
Oh, there you go. Doc had me hands full. Mrs. Jackson thought you could do with a cuppa.
Thank you.
Elizabeth Josephine Birdsworth, pleased to meet you, Mr. Fletcher. Oh, it's good to see a strong young fella as deputy governor, especially with that old bed.
Lizzie.
I'll just fix your tea. Black with a bit of sugar.
Yes, just...
You can always tell a man by the way he takes his tea. Strong with a bit of sweetness. The doc here, he takes white with two. Oh, he's a real sweetheart. I've got to apologise, Mr. Fletcher, for the way some of them women acted out at breakfast. Some of them wouldn't know how to behave like a lady.
Out, Lizzie. Out! You get used to Lizzie. She's almost part of the furniture here.
Well, she seems a harmless enough old lady.
Yes.
I thought you were showing Mr. Fletcher around.
I left him with Greg for a few minutes.
What do you think?
I don't know, really.
You don't sound so keen.
Well, I'm not overly taken with him. He probably needs time to settle in, that's all.
He shouldn't be here and you know it.
Would it have been any better if a woman had replaced you, Vera? I'm sorry, I didn't mean that. Look, let's just give him a chance.
I know these women better than anyone. They'll be out to con him. You wait and see. More experience to do this job than anyone. They had no right to replace me.
You're probably right, Vera.
But he won't have it so easy. I know his type. Thinks he knows it all. Likes to feel important.
You're the officer of the day, aren't you, Miss Bennett? There's a woman at reception waiting to be released.
I'm going there right now, thank you.
I'll see the work areas now, thank you, Miss Jackson.
If you like.
Sign your name, will you? Your name! Will you sign it?
Your name?
Oh, yes.
Oh, funny how she understands when she wants to. Come on, I'll show you to the gate. Well, hurry up. Come with me.
Yes, sis. Goodbye.
Bye-bye. Good luck.
Well, I reckon he's a real gent.
Oh, you know.
Oh, I know a real man when I see him, and he really is that kind.
You figured that all out by yourself, did you, Lizzie?
Well, I don't care if he's got four heads, just so long as he makes Vera feel rotten.
What do you think about Mr. Fletcher, B?
Oh, give us a go, Doreen. I've only seen him once. I shall reserve my opinion until we get to know each other a little better.
Well, I really know him, and I can wind him round my little finger.
Laundry? This is B. Smith, Monica Ferguson, Doreen Anderson, Lizzie Birdsworth.
Oh, we've met already.
Janice?
Yes, all right, Mrs. Jackson. I'm sure I'll get to know them all in time.
That depends on how well you want to get to know us.
Ferguson, you've been behaving yourself for the last few days. Will you keep it that way? You're up before the parole board tomorrow.
Here, I'm a queen bee around here. Sort of union boss?
Well, as far as I'm concerned, Smith, isn't it?
Mrs. Smith.
So as far as I'm concerned, Mrs. Smith, the officers are in charge. And you'll certainly remember that while I'm on duty.
Oh, crikey, he sounds just like Vera.
Any better looking. Doreen, aren't you supposed to be in the garden?
Oh, yeah. Well, you see, Mrs. Jackson, I got lonely.
All right.
Now, just a minute. You'll work where you're supposed to work.
Oh, but...
In the garden.
It's not fair. Everyone picks on me.
Mr. Fletcher?
Oh, well, you can come up and see me any time, big fella.
Yeah, it's easy to see while you're in here, Mrs. Jackson.
Well, up you.
He's not going to be easy to handle.
Well, I think he's real nice.
Oh, shut up, Lizzie. Just so long as he stays out of my way.
Happy birthday.
I'm so sweet.
Irene Servos, you're under arrest. Just hold on to
that.
Excuse me.
Who told you? How did you find out?
I'm with the Immigration Department. Irene Servos is to be held in custody for up to 48 hours, pending her appearance before a stipendary magistrate. She's an illegal immigrant.
We had no alternative but to wait for you.
If there was an interpreter assigned to the prison...
Well, there isn't, and I am not about to discuss policies with you. We'll have to explain the situation to her later.
Why has she been brought back here?
Because the Immigration Detention Center doesn't have the room available. With Irina's record, she will be detained here until her hearing.
What happens to her then?
If the magistrate finds that she's an illegal immigrant, and there seems no doubt that she is... She will be served with another custody warrant.
For how long?
7 days. Until the minister in Canberra decides whether or not she is to be sent back to Greece.
And just exactly where will she be detained, Mrs. Davidson?
Here, or Fairleigh, or a detention centre.
Why can't she stay with her brother, for heaven's sake?
I don't make the rules, I follow them. That will be all, Karen.
Irene?
University seems to be agreeing with Karen Travers.
They don't all end up radicals.
I did. At least my father thought so. Then he taught me that if I wanted to change the system, I should join it and try from the inside. How's Mr. Fletcher's first day going?
He's efficient.
Well, I'd better see him before I go home. Would you get him for me, please, mate?
Give us two, money. Hey, Fletch, how about a light for a load? Look, you know, I must be terribly hard to keep your eyes off us lovelies, but couldn't you leave us alone for a few minutes?
I'll stay here for as long as I see fit.
Got a right one here, girls. Fletch the Letch.
Yeah, he made me work in the garden, a pig.
Well, couldn't you have talked to the governor?
Oh, yeah, I reckon.
Hey, Mr. Butterfield was away for the most of the day. I had the whole nursery to myself.
I hate being by myself.
Oh, I don't mind. Gives me time to think.
Didn't take you long to get back in here.
You're going to have to learn to keep off the streets, kid.
Shut up, Monica. It looks like she's going to be deported. She's an illegal immigrant.
What? And they keep her in for that?
She broke the law.
Yeah, well, maybe she'd be better off in her own country anyhow.
How'd they catch up with you?
Irene thinks the man that blackmailed her into a prostitution found him.
Oh, bloody lager.
What's the matter, Mr. Fletcher? You got something against a girl earning a living off men?
How low you women want to sink is up to you, until you end up in here.
You know, I've been trying to figure you out, Fletch. And now I know. You're one of those male chauvinist pigs, aren't you? Hey, girls, of all the men we have to end up with, a male chauvinist pig. You've got a lot to learn, Fletch.
Mrs. Davidson would like to see you, Mr. Fletcher.
Hey, Mrs. Jackson, can't you tell this perp to leave us alone and give us a bit of privacy?
That's quite enough, Bea.
Yeah, we don't want him gawking at us all the time. He gives us the creeps.
Yeah, go on.
Can't we have a bit of
take
time
off
to ourselves?
I wouldn't be too hard on
him. I'll put a sock in it, Lizzie. Yeah.
What was that all about?
I've handled tougher characters than that.
Look, the women aren't used to being supervised 24 hours a day.
Don't tell me my job, Mrs. Jackson.
Believe me, I wouldn't dream of doing a thing like that. Look, there are times when there's no signs of trouble. The women don't have to be watched quite so closely.
That's just the time you should be watching them.
I'm only trying to make it a little easier for you and perhaps a bit more pleasant.
I know my job, Mrs. Jackson, and I'll do it. And I suggest you keep your pleasantries for your husband.
I have to agree with Mrs. Jackson. However, I am aware there are certain elements which need to be watched. But on the whole, I prefer the women to experience a certain amount of freedom, particularly in their leisure time. They appreciate it, and it is rarely abused.
It's at times that it is abused that I'm concerned with, Mrs. Davidson.
Nevertheless, it is the way I like this prison to be run.
With respect, ma'am, I don't agree.
You are entitled to your opinions, Mr. Fletcher, but may I remind you, you are now working in a women's prison. You are not in Pentridge nor the Army.
I didn't ask for this transfer. I was given this job because the department wasn't happy with certain incidents.
I know very well why you were transferred, Mr. Fletcher. But as long as I am the governor here, I will make the decisions on policy. Now, I suggest you go home, and perhaps tomorrow we can start off on a more even footing.
Ladies.
He's making an impression.
You could say that.
Oh, by the way, I have the Voss's deportation order. She leaves tomorrow. Take care of it, would you?
It hardly seems fair, really.
It's the law.
I just put some dirt in it, that's all. Do you reckon it'll live?
Oh, well, it looks all right. But if it doesn't take, we can plant it in the garden. You're getting quite a green thumb.
Yeah. Hey, do you think you could bring me in some more? We could really do the room up.
No, Vera'd only ripped them out like last time. We're lucky this one's still alive.
Are you two gonna keep yakking all night?
Oh, belt up, Lizzie. We hardly ever get to see one another.
If you ask me, it's the other way around.
Well, nobody asked you.
Well, I'm a bit tired anyway.
Oh, okay.
Night, Doreen.
Night, Lynn.
Morning, Jim.
Morning, Greg. How's it going?
It's early days.
Listen, feel free to drop by my office anytime.
Yes, I might just do that.
How are you getting on with the other officers?
We understand each other. Have you always been the only man on staff here?
No, Bill Jackson worked here when I first arrived.
Jackson?
Yes, he was Meg's husband. He was killed quite a few months ago in a riot.
Oh, hell. Yes, I remember it.
Yes. Yes, I'll let her know.
Oh, Irene, goodbye.
Thank heavens I didn't miss you. Good luck. Kali Tihi.
Yes, ευχαριστώ πάρα πολύ για όλα.
Sorry?
When you're quite finished, Travers.
Mr. Wilson rang. He can't pick you up today.
You've been stood up, have you, Travers?
Morning.
Morning.
I'll take over, thank you, Miss Bennett.
What?
I think I know the procedure.
Hardly be smuggling anything out in books.
Thank you. Come on.
I'd rather Miss Bennett did it.
Hand it over.
Women don't like men going through their handbags, or is that how you get your kicks?
You know the rules about taking out uncensored letters?
I've never seen them before.
Tell your story to the governor.
They're not mine. You've got to believe me. I don't even know where they came from.
Who gave them to you, Lynn?
No one. I've never even seen them before.
Who wrote them?
They're unsigned and printed. We'll never be able to trace them. Did you read these letters?
How could I? I didn't even know they were in my bag.
Then why do they say you'd be the contact to smuggle things out of prison? You must have known.
I didn't! Oh, please, Mrs. Davidson.
Why would you risk losing your job over something like this?
I haven't done anything.
Wait outside.
Of course she's guilty.
Well, I believe her.
Those letters were found in a bag, Mrs. Davidson.
Well, someone could have put them there.
Why?
I don't know, but Lynn Warner has proved to me she can be trusted.
Nobody would write those letters unless they knew they were going to be posted.
I agree.
I think she should be disciplined.
Very well.
Hey, why aren't you at work?
They've stopped me going.
Why'd they do that?
They said I was smuggling out letters. I don't know how they got there, Doreen, but no one will believe me.
I believe you.
Who'd do a thing like that?
Don't you worry. We'll get the bitch who done it. Some rotten mongrel's gone and set you up, Linny. We'll find out who done it.
Yeah, and in the meantime, I'm stuck in here for something I didn't do. Every time something happens in the place, my work release gets stopped. I'm going to lose my job for something that isn't even my fault. God, I hate this place. I hate it.
I suppose you think you're all clever not signing those letters. Covering yourselves in case she got caught. Well, she did. And I'm sure now the governor will think twice before trusting anyone else.
Stupid little fool.
You're all stupid. Ferguson, you're up before the parole board in half an hour. Don't be late.
Are you kidding? I'd even say you ought to be back as deputy governor to get me out of this hole. And if I didn't choke while I was saying it.
I wouldn't count on being paroled if I were you.
Wait till I get my hands on Warner.
Well, I don't reckon she had anything to do with it.
What are you talking about? She smuggled in that yeast for me, didn't she?
Only because you started throwing your weight about, your hefty great elephant.
Listen, if I wasn't getting out of here soon, I'd knock your block off, you old crow.
Oh, you've only got 3 weeks to go anyhow.
Yeah, well, that's 3 weeks too long.
Well, what makes you think they're going to give you a parole?
Because Mrs. Jackson said if I pulled my socks...
What, after you almost killed her?
Yeah, well, that was an accident. She's not one to bear a grudge. Anyway, they didn't put B in solitary, so... Why should they just pull the plug on me?
Because I've done a deal with the governor.
Oh, yeah, like what?
Well, I just wouldn't get my hopes up if I were you.
I could just see the look on Fred's face when I walked through the door. What a celebration.
Do you mean he's going to take you back after you almost knocked him senseless?
No, he always has before. He reckons he can't live without me.
That's because you're shaking his brains loose.
The person that would have done it is that Mr. Fletcher.
Yeah, that'd be right. He'd be just rotten enough to do something like that.
Oh, he'd do nothing of the kind.
Then why wouldn't he let Miss Bennett search me?
They would have been found no matter who searched you, Lynn.
You should see the way he looks at us, Doc. He's cold, you know, real fish, not human.
Oh, stop exaggerating, Doreen.
Well, that should settle you down, Lynn.
I'll see she's okay. Come on, Lynn.
If he didn't do it, then who did? None of the women would have.
Jim certainly seems to have made an impression on those two.
Well, they're not the only ones.
Yeah, well, I'll admit he's not an easy man to get to know. I'm sure he's honest.
Oh, he wouldn't have done that to Lynn, I know that.
Do I detect a note of aggression?
The man's a pompous, over-disciplined bore, Greg. What's in the rule book, that's the law and he's going to lay it down. Forget the individual, they don't count. Women are beneath him, did you know that?
Come on.
And as for working wives and mothers, oh, forget it, they're not in his set of rules.
Meg, what's he been saying to you?
Well, maybe he is right. I didn't do a very good job with Marty, did I? Oh, I'm sorry I'm not lashing out at you.
I know that. This is a side of you I don't very often see. I rather like it.
I missed you last night.
Me too.
Hey, Doc!
Lizzie, how many times do I have to tell you to knock?
Oh, sorry, Mrs. Jackson. You know, Bea told us there was something going on between you, but we thought she was pulling our leg.
There's nothing going on.
Oh, you can trust me, Doc. I won't open me mouth.
What do you want, Lizzie?
Oh, I forgot.
Don't read into a situation which isn't there, Lizzie.
Oh, me? Never. Oh, Mrs. Jackson, you forget I was even here. I never seen a thing.
I saw them kissing, I tell you. Oh, they're in love. You should have seen the way he was holding her real close.
Yeah, well, good luck to her.
I mean, there's a time and place for everything. I mean, somebody might have just walked in and caught them.
Stupid flaming idiots. They can run for all I care.
You should have expected it, Money.
You screws are all alike, aren't you?
Jackson must have known I wouldn't get out. Getting me to act like an angel.
Oh, what's 3 lousy weeks anyhow?
Oh, yeah, come on, Ferguson.
Well, listen, it might mean much to you, but it sure as hell does mean something to me.
Well, yelling's not going to change anything.
I'll yell if I bloody will feel like it.
You don't mind your language, I'll see that you spend part of that time in solitary, Ferguson.
You would, you bloody bitch, wouldn't. Well, I'll give you something to complain about. You bloody hell, you can run for all I care.
You're not making matters worse, Ferguson.
Oh, I'll push your face in, you bitch. You run bloody bitches, the whole bloody lot of you. I hate this blood.
You're going to be sorry, Ferguson. I'll make sure of that.
Not as sorry as you be, you bitch. Oh, bloody run line.
What's going on?
Ferguson's going crazy. You can't go in there.
I never get out of this bloody rotten, stinking place. Promises. I promise you this and they'd stop everything.
Ferguson, stop that right now.
I am fed up to here with being given bloody orders.
I haven't even begun yet. To begin with, clean up this mess. Now!
Mate. Come on. Mate.
One thing you better learn about me, Ferguson. I only ever give an order once.
Every time one of you brainless idiots loses your temper, we get stuck with the cleaning up.
Okay, okay.
I was very impressed by the way you handled her, Mr. Fletcher. That's exactly what's needed around here.
More strong-arm tactics, you mean?
Well, it's just that we haven't had anyone capable of putting a stop to an outburst like that.
I hope, Miss Bennett, I never have to do that again.
Some other women deserve it.
Are you excusing physical force?
Of course not. And I will have to report this assault to the governor. She doesn't approve of such things.
And what about you, Miss Bennett? Do you approve of such things?
You're the one used to bashings. Isn't that the way you did things in Pentridge?
Well, if you'd want to take it out on something, why didn't you attack the washers? And then we could have gotten out of doing the work.
Since when have you done any work anyway?
Laughing at
you. What is so funny?
I reckon Fred should have been here. To see you get laid out. He could have seen you getting what you normally dish out to him.
Mr. Ferguson, I'd like a word with you, please, outside. Ooh.
This gorilla tries thumping me again. I want witnesses.
You only got to yell.
What's happening?
Shh. I can hear him talking, but I can't hear what he's saying. Monty's not saying a word.
I reckon it looks like shock set in. He apologised.
What?
Said he hoped he hadn't hurt me.
There you are. I told you he was a gentleman.
He reckoned he should have been more sympathetic to why I was so mad. Oh, yeah? Well, I reckon you've had all the sympathy you're going to get for the day. All right, everybody out. Hey! Hey, who's going to help me clean up this mess?
I should ask your friend Fletch.
Gone.
Yeah, I know. But I want to get this bit looking good. It's kind of a help having you out here, Lynn.
Hey, Warner. You've really gone and done it this time, eh?
I didn't do it, Ben.
Oh, I suppose they got in your bag by themselves.
Lynn's innocent. Fletch planted him on her.
Oh, bull.
No gentleman had to do a thing like that.
What are you standing up for him for? You don't know what he's like.
We know enough. Mind you, I wouldn't mind learning a bit more about him.
Yeah, well, I wouldn't.
You know, you got to learn not to be so stupid, Warner.
I'll leave her alone, B.
Are you threatening me, Doreen?
Oh, afternoon, Mrs. Jackson.
Lizzie, how are you feeling, Lynn?
Fine, thanks.
Any trouble?
Looks like spring's come round early this year, wouldn't you say, Lizzie?
Yeah, and some people fall for each other any old time.
Yeah, or any old where.
That is the one thing I will not tolerate, Mr. Fletcher. These are women, and there is no excuse for physical force under any circumstances.
I didn't exactly hit her, Mrs. Davidson.
Bring her in, Miss Bennett. Whether you hit her or not,
she could have been seriously hurt.
Do you want to lay a charge against Mr. Fletcher?
Huh. What good would that do?
You still have your rights in here, Ferguson.
He never hurt me.
You don't have to be afraid, Ferguson. Tell the truth.
I asked for it. Pity my Fred hasn't got a few of your guts. Could respect a man like that.
That'll be all. You can go. Well, if there are no charges, Mr. Fletcher, we'll forget the matter.
Ma'am, but I'm not excusing myself for what I did, and I'm certainly not proud of it. I'm not in the habit of knocking people around, especially women.
Thank you, Miss Williams. A new prisoner has arrived. Perhaps you would like to take Mr. Fletcher with you. Show him the procedure we follow.
Yes, Mrs. Davidson.
We have a right to live our own lives. It's our business, no one else's.
I just don't like people talking about me, that's all.
There's nothing to feel guilty about, Meg.
I know.
You sure?
Oh, I just feel so humiliated.
Look, we've got... You don't just turn your back on feelings. We're mature people, and we've got something rather special going for us. Now, what's to feel humiliated in that?
One of us is a little more mature.
Meg, does it really matter that much?
Joyce Deirdre Martin, you've been sentenced to 6 months' imprisonment, having been found guilty of accessory after the fact in relation to an armed holdup and receiving of stolen goods. Is that correct?
That's right, love.
You'll address the officers by name, with the title of Miss or Mrs.
Which one are you, love?
Over here, Martin.
So what's your name?
Fletcher.
You know, there's something familiar about you. Where would I know you from?
I'm quite sure we've never met.
Oh, I never forget a face. Always forgetting names, but never a face, love.
Miss Bennett, and you'll remember it.
Whatever you say, love. Hey, I've got it. Do you remember Harry Martin, always in and out of Pentridge? My husband. And you were one of the screws. Oh, struth, that's right. I was always popping in to visit Harry. There was something he told me about you. Now, what was it?
I'm sure I don't know.
Nah, can't remember. It'll come to me.
Oh, come on, V, you're shuffling the flaming spots off them.
Hey, Dor, how about making up a foursome?
I'm giving them up.
What's got into her? As if I didn't know.
I wonder what's wrong with Karen. She was so quiet in the dining room, sort of upset.
Don't know why she should be. Everything's going her way.
Yeah.
Well, don't worry, Lynn, you'll be okay.
Ladies, this is Joyce Martin. This is B. Smith. She'll show you around.
Oh, Mrs. Jackson, thought you might like to know I won't be seeing my Fred for another 3 weeks.
Sorry.
Be okay if I had other interests like other people I could mention.
I did the best I could.
How does that saying go? A doctor a day keeps the blues away.
Cut it out, Monty.
What are the stakes?
Got any fags? This is Lizzie. This is Monty.
Pleased to meet you.
G'day.
What'd you get?
6 months.
What for?
Spending some of my husband's money.
You want to let us in on the joke?
Well, he pulled a little job. I needed some money for housekeeping. They caught me.
Well, what did he get?
For once in his life, he didn't get caught. Mind you, I shouldn't complain. Been living off his jobs for 15 years.
Ever been in before?
Yeah, once. Served 2 months when I was, 17, I think it was. Yeah, this is my lucky day.
She gets 6 months and it's her lucky day. Now I've heard it all.
I couldn't be happier.
Can't figure it out. Why should someone be so happy about landing up inside? There's more to her than she's letting on. What do you reckon, Dor?
Huh? What was you saying?
Oh, forget it. I might as well talk to me bloody self.
Hmm.
okay, Lynn?
Yeah, I'm all right.
Jackson, I've been doing some thinking, and I owe you an apology. And what I'm trying to say is, do you mind if we start again?
All right, Mr. Fletcher. Ferguson.
Good morning.
Morning, Mr. Ferguson.
Seem to have won a heart.
Not the only one I have.
Come on, you two, up you get. Morning, Lizzie.
Oh, just once I'd like to be allowed to sleep in.
Get out of there.
Does he have to come into our rooms?
Hurry up, Doreen.
What are you staring at?
I'll have none of that in here, Anderson.
None of what? You're a perv, Mr. Fletcher.
You're disgusting.
Mr. Fletcher?
What would he know?
How can you possibly turn a blind eye to that sort of thing?
I don't think it's too harmful, Mr. Fletcher.
It's got to be stopped.
I think you're reading too much into this. Sometimes it's just for little love and affection. I don't think that hurt anyone.
Homosexuality's out in my book, and between women it's sickening.
There are a couple of young girls who are no doubt holding on to each other for a little comfort. I don't classify them as homosexuals, and I certainly won't judge them.
This is the life, eh? Not a care in the world.
Sleep well?
Ah, like a log.
Yeah, I didn't. I was awake all night trying to figure out why anyone would want to spend 6 months in here.
You can put up with anything if you got something special waiting for you outside.
Yeah, well, I got Fred, but I still want to get out of here.
I'm used to not seeing Harry. In 15 years of marriage, he's been 8 inside. No, I've just discovered more important things in life.
I gotta have been in here too long. Harry finally hit the jackpot. Got away with over $150,000.
Armored truck job. Trouble is, he had to get away in a kind of hurry, so guess who had to look after the money? I'm the only one who knows where it is. Uh-huh. And that little secret I'm keeping right to myself. I got 6 easy months figuring out how I'm gonna spend it.
Don't take any notice of him, Lynn.
I saw the way he looked at me.
So what? We didn't do nothing wrong. Don't you like me anymore?
Oh, of course I do. It's just... He's...
Yeah, well, we got nothing to be ashamed of, and we shouldn't worry about what people think.
I guess I always have.
Yeah, well, let them think what they like. You've got to learn to stand up for yourself.
Thought you'd like to hear about your job in the nursery, Warner.
Yeah?
Mr. Butterfield rang.
Oh, I can go back to...
You're finished.